Welcome back to another ORM Mastery tutorial. Don't forget you can access all the tutorials in this course. There is a link in the video description. And of course, if you love this course, then you can go ahead and use our link in the video description to get the best price for our Udemy course. Well, getting straight into this from the previous tutorial, we learned that running queries or reverse queries in certain situations was not possible. And we discovered that there was a keyword that we could utilize in order to actually build a query, a reverse query, in a situation where we had a many-to-many relationship. In the case where a many-to-many or one-to-many relationship is defined and a related name is not specified, Django provides a related manager. The related manager, or sometimes described as the underscore set reverse lookup class, is created by Django, providing the ability for reverse lookups. So the underscore set object, I'll bring it on, underscore set object is made available, again, when related name is not specified. That sounds a little bit disjointed, but if you come from the previous tutorial, we know, for example, or we've seen in the past that foreign keys, we normally utilize a related name, and that allows us to develop those reverse lookups when running queries. Now, what we saw with a many-to-many, we can specify, of course we can specify the related name, but if we don't, what we're saying here in the case of a many-to-many or one-to-many relationship, where the related name is not specified, Django provides a related manager. Django creates a related manager that allows us to utilize this keyword set. So let's see that in action again. Now, this code has all been loaded from the previous tutorial. We're just following on here. Now, we saw that previously. So, for example, what we tried to do is we tried to grab all the categories associated with name one, which is obviously one category. And then what we tried to do is we tried to, utilizing cat.product.all, we're running the query here to look for all the categories that are associated to product. And we received an error: category object has no attribute product. So here we can't perform this reverse lookup. Now, because we haven't supplied our related name in the many-to-many field, behind the scenes, we now have this related manager that we can utilize. So we saw an example of that. So instead of running cat.product.all, we use the underscore set all, and then that provides the tools for us to then run a reverse lookup. You can, if you like, try it for yourself. If you were to, for example, add a related name here, equals, and then let's just try category. Okay, so if you were to add a related name in your model, then let's just go ahead and let's exit this. You will need to exit. Let's go ahead and make migrations make migrations. Let's make those changes and migrate. Okay, so we've made those changes. So behind the scenes now, we don't have the related manager. So let's go back into the shell and let's just load this up again. You will find all of this code in the queries markdown file. So I'm just going to run this all in. Okay, so I've just gone ahead and imported category product and product category. You find that at the top of the queries markdown file. Again, you just find it here. If you need any help. Okay, so I'm just running these commands here. So let's go ahead and check our tables, just make sure what we've got. Okay, so it looks like we've got some products in our tables. Of course, we could use the Explorer if we wanted to. So let's go ahead and run this query again. So let's grab category one. Okay, so that grabs category one here. Let's go ahead now and try the cat product set all. Now notice that this time, because we have already defined the related name, we cannot run the underscore set anymore. So that isn't possible. Sorry, it's a bit confusing here. So product set all. So that isn't possible anymore. However, if we revert back to just product, you can see that we still have no object. So let's refer to category. This is the related name. And you can see that that does then refer back, or that does provide us the ability to then run our query. Now notice I use the keyword here, replace the keyword product to category, and obviously then that matches the related name. It's this type of detail that can be really handy when developing with Django, particularly when maybe you're working on existing systems or maybe reviewing code.